Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel, and today we're gonna review this brand new camera bag from KNF Concept. Okay, test zone. KNF Concept sent me this camera bag to make this video review and to share with you guys the good, the bad and the sexy, at least at my opinion. They also sent me this square 100mm filter holder to test out, but that it's for another video. To start, I like to point out the importance of a camera bag. A camera bag, it isn't just a bag, but a place where the expensive camera and the expensive camera stuff will spend most of its time. If a camera bag can't take multiple hits and not protect the goods inside, it isn't a camera bag. Also, the job of a camera bag is like a watch. It tells the time, but also tells who you are. For example, if you have a Casio G-Shock or a Rolex as a watch, it gives different image of yourself. By unboxing this camera bag, I found that there is a small pouch with a really cool cleaning kit, with some wipers inside of it, brush, and a mini water spray. Yeah, this is really nice to come with the camera bag. Eventually, you will need to buy one thing like that to clean your lenses or your camera, okay? Also, there is a lot of dividers that probably you just need two or three, but you have a lot of them. That's good. So let's cut to the chase. This is not a bag for a big DSLR. For that, KNF Concept have a different bags just for that, okay? This is more for entry-level cameras like the Sony A6000 series or Canon M series or Micro Four Thirds series and most of the mirrorless cameras series. Yeah, this camera bag will be a perfect fit for that type of cameras, not really big DSLRs. As well, this isn't a backpack. This is a shoulder bag. Boom. So this is for advanced amateur photographers. Hell yeah! There is a small problem. I don't have a digital camera that size. So for testing this camera bag, I went with a film camera from my vintage collection. I did use this camera bag in a different way, but I will share it at the end of this video review, okay? So here is how I imagine someone will use this camera bag. With internal divisors, it was really easy to configure a cozy space for all my stuff. Here is the camera section. Here is another segment for the second lens. And there is a third one, small one, for something like a flash or extra batteries, or as I am using here, to hold some filters. There we go. In the front pocket has more space as well for extra batteries, SD cards, more filters and so on. Also in here you can check out, there is a zipper for a pocket to put some valuables in here. I don't use it, but it's good to know that it's there. So talking about pockets in the back, without any zip, it has another pocket. So without a zip, this pocket is a very fast and convenient access from stuff that you put here. Well then, the good. I really like a camera bag that you can use it with just one hand. Okay, magnetic holders and connected zippers make this one-hand action really a breeze. KNF Concept adds this four metal pointy bases supports so it can benefit from not touching the ground directly and not slipping all as well. So I'm gonna show you a really cool thing. This is the coolest thing that I saw in a camera bag. If you want to use this camera bag as just a bag, not a camera bag, just a bag, check this out. Just remove the section that you have the goods of the camera bag, and there you have a really roomy big bag. And let's observe also one thing. this module here has a really smooth and thick protection for all your gear. I really like this. And the back pocket is a very handy thing. I put my wallet, my keys and my phone here because it's much more convenient than having this stuff on myself, especially if I'm walking or hiking. Yeah, this is really handy to just access your smartphone like so, as the smartphones are getting bigger and bigger on your pocket. It's kind of annoying, okay? Another positive thing is it is a shoulder bag. You can use this bag combined with other backpacks, like a normal backpack, a camping backpack, a picnic backpack, a school backpack, a laptop backpack, World War II radio backpack, and having the camera accessible quickly. This isn't the great camera bag in the world. There is some things that I don't really like, that I really have some doubts. For example, I don't believe this design is effective on the rain. Okay, it will protect somewhat a little bit from the rain, but I guess some rain can slip through here. But also I don't believe that this type of photographer will adventure himself on tropical rain.
We are in July and from nowhere it starts to rain like hell. And lightning, the most powerful flash in the planet. And I'm taking some pictures.
Yeah. Another thing, I kinda wish that the interior wall was 100% covered on Velcro material, because the dividers are big enough to use some creative separation like diagonal separation or horizontal separation as well. With just these two straps, you can't really do that. That is too bad. It's a good looking camera bag. I mean, look at it. As a lot of camera makers today are using the retro look camera, this camera bag will visually be suitable with these new trends. Another thing, honestly, it's the price. Okay, it's not an expensive bag. There is this type of bags way more expensive than this one, but this one, I think it's a reasonable price for it. It's not cheap, it's just a fair price, honestly. To conclude this video, I want to show you how I will use this bag. I did use this bag for the last 4 days as a video bag, not a really a photographer bag, but a video bag for YouTube. So for now on, I will use it to put the stuff that I use to make YouTube videos, as I am taking seriously this YouTube channel, and my old camera bag, it's good enough to hold my photography stuff, but not big enough for video YouTube stuff. So yeah, I just organized my camera bag for YouTube video tutorials. Let's see what we have inside. If I open this, and immediately on the front, you can see that I have some filters for the Yolandi U-Rig that I am using right now to make the close-up, okay? Also, I have here this small filter holder. This is really handy if you want to use the filters on a smartphone without using the big thing of the U-Rig. I have some cleaning cloth as well, very important. Also, I have here, deep down here, a wide-angle lens, as well an SD card, because it's always a good idea to have extra SD cards. Another cleaning cloth that came with this camera bag, with a really beautiful branding here on the side of saying KNF Concept, really, really nice. And also I have here a smartphone microphone if I really need to use it. Okay, let's put back. And inside we have a bunch of stuff. So for starters, I have this small bag that I have for years, and inside I have a light for smartphones or for my camera. And this light is really handy because it's small and can fit on almost any bag. Also, I have here a gimbal for a smartphone. So this is a review that will come next week. And finally, my Sony camera that I use to film these YouTube videos. And there we go. So So if you want to buy this camera, the links is down below on the description. And yeah, drop a like if you learned something, comment down below if you have any questions, and subscribe if you want to see more stuff like this. I am Miguel, until next time, see ya.